Blues fans, this is Anthony from Texas Blues Alley. It's been too long since we've had Free Lesson Friday, but I'm going to do my best to make it up to you. What you're going to watch today and what you're going to learn is taken right from one of our new full courses called Jimmy's Influence Volume 2. This section, what you just heard at the beginning, comes from the solo inspired by Hear My Train A-Comin'. Now, I picked this section because it sounds simple, but it's deceptively hard. It's a little counterintuitive the way you're going back and forth between the low and the high notes, so I think you're really going to like it. Now, obviously, if you like what's in this lesson, then this exact format is followed throughout the course. It's 3+ hours long. You'll learn 2 solos. You can find out more about it at texasbluesalley.com/jimmy2. But the other thing I want to do before we get into it is just explain why we haven't had any free lessons for a while. So you can skip this if you don't care, but, you know, if you care about why lessons come out and stop, then you might want to pay attention. So back in the beginning of November, I posted a blog entry on Texas Blues Alley that said 3 things that you can expect before the end of the year. And there were 3 things that I laid out. The first was a big new feature for our pro player. That's the online video audio tablature player that members of our subscription program, the locals, that's what they use to watch courses. And I finished the big new feature, which was called Instant Loops, and people could now loop over a lick in a soloing lesson just by clicking a little entry, and it instantly starts looping. So that took a lot of work to finish, but it's done and it's cool. The second thing I said was something new for Thanksgiving, for the Thanksgiving ballad. Well, that new thing turned out to be a live performance, but not just any live performance. I built a stage up in the upstairs level of our barn. I'm currently set up in the basement, but I built a stage in the middle level, which took about, 2 weeks straight of work. And then I decorated the inside and I got some friends of mine to come together and we shot a performance of the Thanksgiving ballad right there as kind of a sign of things to come from Texas Blues Alley. And then the last thing, as soon as that was done, I couldn't even enjoy it. I had to turn around and immediately start working on this course. If you like this free lesson, please check out the course. And even if you just watch the lesson, I hope you enjoy it. When we get to lick 3, we're going to step up the intensity a little bit. You can hear on the demonstration that I kick on my vibe pedal. I'm going to leave that off for now so that it's not distracting. Basically, we're going to play something, then we're going to play an alternate version of it, then play the first thing again, and then almost play the second thing again for the fourth one, but we're going to do a little different. So the first thing that we play is 5 to 7 on the A string. Then low E open, and then 5 to 6 on the D string. And then back down to the low E string. And then to the 5th fret of the A string. And then a little rake, 3rd fret of the low E string, open. Okay? That little rake is important. So that's the first thing that you do. The next time through, you go, do this hammer on 5 to 7 on A, 5 to 6 on D, then open, then you back strum the high E and B string. And come in here, and then the rest of it is the same. Now, if the fourth one wasn't kind of special, if you just wanted to play an ongoing thing using those two things, you would just alternate them and you'd get. Okay, so that's a cool little thing to get used to the rhythm. So what you got to remember, though, is when you're playing a solo, when you get to the fourth one, what you would normally play is... But we're going to do it a little bit differently. So you got one... Two... Three... And then when we get to four, you go... Let's take a look at that. You do this. You start off the same way, except that instead of playing it here, you're going to do it down here. Open to two on D. Open to one on the G string. To the high E string. Then a bend on the third fret of the B string. So you bend up on the third fret of the B string, bending the G string with it. And you switch to the G string at the top of the bend. And let the G string come back down. So you don't let the B string ring out. And you do that two times in a row. And then at the very end. And that takes us into the next section. So you got a little bend here. And then pull off the open on the G string. Second fret of the D string, open. Okay? So once again, you play the first thing. Play the second thing. Play the first one again. Then you kind of play the second thing again with that little twist at the end.